Hello. I am Harvey. Today's video is about Balam Whiplash Part 15 on hard difficulty. Before we start, let me tell you that Quistis event is actually the very first character event that I covered in this channel. Time really flies. Anyways, let's get into the quest. I am skipping Quistis for now. Therefore, I will complete it with Quistis at crystal level 51 and character level 50, who also using the 1-star whip. The quest is actually pretty easy to do with Kuja, it is almost like no need a guide for that. The first wave contains 3 splashers. If you haven't complete the Chocobo panel missions, here is where you can get a lot of splasher kills. They are just normal splashers which will not attack you for a turn after their HP is under 50%. Very easy to deal with. The second wave are a Cockatrice and a Lamia. Quistis is a female character. Therefore, if you get lucky and Lamia is targeting Quistis for its first turn, you can savvily take care of the Cockatrice first. Otherwise, it is better to deal with Lamia first. And that's it for this wave. For the third wave, we are up against a Sand Kraken. Its turn rate is extremely high after using Sand Flurry level 1 at its first action. Therefore, do not ever let it act. Although my Quistis in the party is pretty weak, the Degenerator Whip from her is enough to buy the team enough time to kill it. Here is where you want to use the Degenerator Whip, by the way. You don't really need Quistis to beat in the final wave. The fourth wave is just 2 Chakratises. Same deal as that in wave 2, and you should be good to go. We are up against 2 Tears Eyes at the final wave. Well, what they are is not really important. The important point is that there are 2 bosses, which means that Kuja is going to destroy them. Actually, 2 things that are important, I guess. Tears Eyes are weak against fire, earth, and wind elements, but strong against water element. Choose wisely with your summon. My personal choice will be the brothers, as they can benefit my bravery batteries a lot. Ifrit and Painmonium are not bad choices as well. Choose whatever fit for your team. Second thing to pay attention to is that the boss will empower itself when one of them dies. The empowered boss hit very hard and acts extremely quick. You would not want to deal with that. Therefore, try to kill them both at the same time. After that, you are done with the quest. Well, even though you can complete the quest with a very weak Quistis, I recommend you to pull for her anyways. She is a very good support character that you might want. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.
仲間がいるから戦えるんだ。